cannabis is now legal in Canada. Wait. Why am I excited? I don't even smoke. What's up, people? In Canada, cannabis has been legalized on October 17th, 2018, nationwide. That's right, the country legalized cannabis on that day, leaving many Canadians looking like this. And that was just after the first puff. Wait until the munchies kick in. So today, I've decided to talk about weed from two perspectives. I will talk about it from an Islamic perspective as a Muslim, then I'll talk about it from a societal perspective in Canada as a Canadian. Now, just to be clear, I have never smoked weed in my life. I've never gotten high, I've never consumed an edible, more so, I've never consumed alcohol or gone drunk, never smoked cigarettes, I've never even vaped. Ladies and gentlemen, I am what is commonly referred to as a buzzkill. I kinda like that, sounds pretty cool. Let's start off with the Islamic perspective. In Islam, consuming anything that is psychoactive or is an intoxicant, or in Arabic we refer to as yudhib al-aqil, that is considered haram, or against our religion. This includes alcohol and other intoxicants and many other drugs that are also psychoactive. Those are considered against the teachings of Islam. Does that mean no Muslim in the entirety of history has ever done any of these before? You should meet some of my colleagues. Of course, there are Muslims who consume drugs and alcohol and whatnot. However, they are against the teachings of Islam.
Ask a Muslim scholar, your local imam, or any person of knowledge. Please avoid asking your local drug dealer, as conflicts of interest may arise. Some exceptions may occur due to your medical condition. Ask your scholar if this advice is right for you.
Now for the societal perspective. When the whole cannabis legalization thing was happening, there were two distinct extreme perspectives. Some people were like, this is the best day in the world, best day ever. To that, I say, no, the best thing in the world would be to eliminate corruption and world poverty. Then on the other end of the spectrum, some people were like, this is the worst day in the world, this is Armageddon, worst news ever. And to that, again, I say, no, the worst thing is probably corruption and world poverty. Now, let's talk about the legalization. Different provinces have different rules, as in what is the legal age, the do's and don'ts, the smoke-free zones, etc. Depending on what province you're in, you can always go to the government's website and check out what the rules are, what the guidelines are. I'm just here to make a quick point about legalizing cannabis. When products like alcohol and cigarettes and even gambling are all legal, but then something like weed is illegal, and not only illegal, but also criminalized in many cases, that doesn't make too much sense. Now there's always arguments for legalization versus simply decriminalization. Those are two deep topics that I'm not gonna talk about them right now. Weed has a lot more health benefits and less drawbacks than other products such as alcohol and cigarettes. So of all the drugs and all the addictions and all the intoxicating and psychoactive elements they contain, weed is probably the lesser of the evils. I'm not saying everybody should go out and smoke weed and get high, but what I'm trying to say is that weed is probably the least of your concerns. It's probably the least thing you should be worried about when things like alcohol, for example, is out there. Now, let's clarify some things. The government isn't legalizing cannabis because they suddenly decided it's the right thing to do. No, they saw it as an opportunity to make money. They were probably thinking, hold on a sec, are you telling me that if I legalize cannabis, I can not only control the supply, control the process, and monitor all the activity, but I can also make tons of money?
Light bulb.
I have an idea. On the first day of legalization, provinces made a lot of money. Some provinces made $250,000, some provinces made $700,000. Even Nova Scotia made approximately $660,000 on day one. Of course, this isn't expected to happen every day. This was only opening day, and sales are expected to spread out over the year, but there is some really good money in it for the government. However, some provinces are taking it a little too far. A New Brunswick government agency is providing services on how to roll a joint. I think the government forgot the very first rule of drug dealing. Don't get high off of your own supply. However, for the most part, government agencies are doing very good. They've taken the correct measures, correct approaches when legalizing weed. They're spreading awareness about the health risks and health benefits, the do's and the don'ts, the laws and the guidelines around it. So overall, this isn't Armageddon. The government has done pretty well so far in spreading awareness about this entire legalization process and made a good chunk of change around it too. So, in conclusion, legalization or not, I won't be smoking weed, I won't be eating edibles, nor will I be consuming alcohol or anything else. But overall, I don't think the legalization of cannabis is the worst thing ever. I don't think it's Armageddon. I don't think it's awful news. It's not the worst thing that could happen. For everyone out there, whether you're for or against, do your own research. Learn about the benefits and the drawbacks to both public health and the economy. Hear both sides of the story, and then make your own decision. Until then, thank you very much for watching. Assalamu alaikum, and peace be with you.
If this video gives you a stroke, diarrhea, constipation, internal bleeding, or any abdominal discomfort, ask your doctor if racism is right for you. Ignorance sold separately, logic not included.